Hello everyone, I hope you're doing fine. My name is Skyline, and today I'm here to address this new setting with McCree that everyone's kind of up in a tussle about. Recoil recovery aim composition, a new setting that was added into the PTR. Now, before we explain this, we need to figure out exactly what recoil recovery compensation is. That is a mechanic that's specific to Overwatch that Blizzard has implemented into, well, any gun that has camera wobble. There are other weapons in the game that actually move your camera, like Zenyatta is one that I know of just from experience, but none of them are as pronounced as McCree. Most of them are extremely subtle, you'd barely even notice by playing. But McCree's is very pronounced, and people generally refer to this as recoil. Okay, and it is recoil, that's what it is. But Blizzard is nice enough to not require players to have any sort of recoil control. Basically, you click the button, and recoil happens, but the game automatically centers you back into the screen every time. However, because there are a lot of players from other games that have recoil control, Blizzard has made it so that even though you don't have to control McCree's recoil, you can control McCree's recoil if you choose to. For today's example, we're using CSGO, and we're using the Deagle. So the Desert Eagle is not really exactly like McCree's gun at all, but it's a little bit similar in that when you shoot, generally the second shot's goes up. Now it's kind of wild gun, it's a little bit random, but generally the second shot goes up like McCree. Now of course in Counter-Strike there is no recoil compensation like Blizzard has in Overwatch, so it just goes up and you have to deal with it. How do you deal with it? Well, you pull your crosshair down. Notice I pulled my crosshair is down here and yet it shot in the center. Now remember, in Counter-Strike there is no recoil recovery compensation thing like Blizzard put in. It's just straight up recoil. So I had to put my crosshair down here in order for the shot to land in the center. We can see a little bit more of an extreme example using something like the M4. So if you just let this thing go, it goes all over the place. If we actually control our spray, it all goes in the center. And notice that our crosshair, it winds up down here. So what does this mean for us Overwatch players? Well, as a player coming from Counter-Strike and other games with recoil compensation, it feels pretty natural. Well, if McCree's gun kicks up, it feels natural to kick down with the mouse, which is what I just did there. I actually just kicked down with the mouse. And yet, the crosshair stays in the center. So Blizzard has made a cool sort of hybrid system where you can compensate for the recoil, or you can just let the computer compensate for the recoil. You do get actually a little bit of an advantage, though, if you compensate. So this is not like some people think. Some people think that it just locks your movement, like there's some sort of, people call it like a threshold for vertical mouse movement when you have recoil. No, that is the recoil. I'll show you. So let's look at this light. If I just click, note where the crosshair kicks up to. I'll draw it for you on the screen. This is with no compensation on my part. But if I compensate myself and drag down after each shot, now notice when I compensate myself, the crosshair actually stays on the light and does not kick up at all because I'm compensating for it. I'm going against the recoil. There is no vertical threshold thing that people are talking about. That is literally the recoil. So the mouse goes up that much, I need to compensate that much for it to stay on the light. But because of Blizzard's system, if I don't compensate all the way, it still goes to the center regardless. Now, if I overcompensate, if I fight through the recoil and then continue to go even further down, notice that I actually end up below the light because I went beyond the recoil. So my mouse moved basically this distance. Even though it looked like my crosshair went from here to here, it actually went from up here to down here because that's where the crosshair ends up. Remember, the recoil puts up to this line up here, so I need to actually fight the recoil, go down here, and then continue downward, like that. On that same note, if I want to ride up with the recoil, so if I want to, like, for example, aim up at that bot, I don't need to move my mouse barely anything, because the recoil is already putting me up at this level, so I just need to move a little bit more to be, you know, up at wherever the bot is, like that. I barely moved my mouse up. And moving your mouse up during McCree's recoil will trigger the recoil compensation to break off. So notice how normally it goes back, but if I move my mouse upward during this, it actually breaks away from the recoil recovery completely. It doesn't recover at all, it just straight up goes up. Notice how my crosshair goes from here to here and up. So a few people have asked about Counter-Strike. That's why I showed the Counter-Strike example. If you come from a game with recoil, having this setting on, recoil recovery on, will feel much more natural because you are actually playing with the recoil. If your recoil is up and you go up, you end up far higher than you normally would be. If your recoil is up and you go down, you would, you know, you are higher than you would be still because the crosshair is going up from the recoil. Now, if we turn it off, this removes all of that. So if we go here, McCree, remember it's here in the controls for hero settings, and we turn it off, that removes any recoil at all. It's like his gun doesn't have recoil. So if we do the same thing, I'm going to, remember this is how it is normally, I'm going to fight the recoil down and try to stay on the light again. Oh no, I can't do that. If I fight the recoil and stay on the light, sure it stays there for a second, but it immediately jumps down. With this setting off, the crosshair will always just do the same up and down motion no matter what. No matter where you move your crosshair, there's no recoil at all. Even if you fight it, it just goes down. On the same note, if you go up, it doesn't go up. Normally, like we just saw, if I shoot and try to break away up, I would normally be like up here. But with this setting off, I'm normally over here. Personally, right now the setting's off, by the way. Personally, I like this setting on a lot because, well, I come from Counter-Strike, so I'm used to using recoil to my advantage, and it just feels very unnatural to have your actual movement disconnected from where the crosshair is. When it's off, the movement of your mouse doesn't actually relate to your crosshair. Notice how the crosshair is bumping, the crosshair is going up and down constantly, but I can't actually control it. The crosshair might be up here, theoretically, like up here, but in reality, my real crosshair is somewhere over here because of the up and down. You can't control it at all. So a lot of times you're just guessing where you're at. Whereas with the setting on, we'll switch it on one more time. I can actually control the crosshair. So you see there's not nearly as much up and down bobbing. Notice my crosshair is staying pretty solid, actually. Pretty firm, not really bobbing up and down a lot, because I can control the recoil. So my screen doesn't need to go crazy. So I think that actually the most competitive setting is by far on, but it also will just feel more natural from Counter-Strike players. Notice how my crosshair is staying rock solid in the center of the screen because I'm fighting it. And even if I'm not, well, I still always know where my crosshair actually is because at any time I can control it. So notice at the peak, I can control it. I can control, at the peak of the recoil, I can always tell exactly where my crosshair is going to go. It's not going to do this weird up, down, up thing. I can see a brand new player to FPSs who has never dealt with recoil before being okay with the off setting. So if you are brand new to the game, you've never played with recoil before in any other games, you might want to try the off setting and see how you like it. But for me, I just really, really like the ability to be able to do whatever you want with the crosshair. If you want to keep it exactly on people's heads, you can do that. But with the off setting, you have no choice but to be dealing with a camera that's going up and down all the time. With the on setting, you can actually control it. So let me know which setting you prefer. My final verdict, like I said, is that the 100% competitive setting, if you want to be as good of a player as possible, is to have the setting on. It just gives you too much control to toss it out. Also, you know this thing you're listening to right now, this outro music? Man, I have to give a immense shout out to Clubfrills. He is the guy who made this music, plus a couple other pieces of music for me that I'll be featuring in other videos. This like chill Overwatch theme. It's so cool. I'll link his SoundCloud down in the description. So just give a huge thanks to Clubfrills for me, because man, I love this outro, and it looks like a lot of other people do as well. So huge thanks, and of course huge thanks to everyone else in my community is helping me out as well. They'll get their own shoutouts in their own separate videos. Never forget to stay positive, and have a great day. Peace out, guys.